Hello and welcome to my channel for history and geopolitics. I'm your host, Blue Tiger. In my videos, I'm dedicated to explore historical and geopolitical topics and to provide accurate information and analysis based on multiple perspectives and independent sources. Today's topic is the Soviet Union and whether and how that superpower could have won the Cold War. The main sources of today's video include one American, one Russian, and several third-party sources, Bulgarian and Dutch ones. So we have equally both Eastern and Western perspectives of this problem. So back to the main topic. The Cold War was a long global political and ideological conflict between the capitalist West and the communist East, which has begun with the proclamation of the Truman Doctrine in 1947 and continued until the truce agreed by the chairman of the Soviet Union Supreme Council, Mikhail Gorbachev, and the US President George W. Bush. This summit happened aboard of Maxim Gorky cruise ship near to the coast of Malta Island in December 1989. During these negotiations, Mikhail Gorbachev admitted the defeat of the Soviet Union and accepted the US peace conditions. Nowadays, most people consider that the Soviet Union was weaker economically than the capitalist West and therefore inevitably lost the Cold War. To verify if this is true, we are going to look in details at the economic indicators and evidences provided by scientists studied that era. Finally, we will try to give an answer to the question, could the Cold War have ended otherwise? First, let's compare the situation in the USSR and United States immediately after the end of World War II. Actually, it is quite the opposite. The Soviet Union suffered enormous damage during the war. The Soviet human losses include 8,700,000 casualties and between 10 and 20 million civilian deaths. Exact figures of civilian losses are disputed. Additionally, the USSR also suffered gigantic material losses, including the destruction of 1,710 cities and towns, 70,000 villages, 32,000 production plants, 6 million buildings, 65,000 kilometers of railway tracks. The colossal moral and psychological damage that the people of the Soviet Union suffered can hardly be measured. Russian historians say that every family in the European part of the Soviet Union lost at least one member between the years 1941 and 1945. The United States, on the other side, has no fighting on its own territory and has suffered almost no destruction except the ones in Pearl Harbor in Hawaii Islands. Because of these drastic differences between Soviet Union and USA losses, a serious economic growth comparison between the both superpowers should be made after 1951. Between 1945 and 1951, the Soviet Union succeeded in making a large-scale restoration of its infrastructure, industry, and agricultural economic sector from the severe damage suffered during the war with Nazi Germany. So, let's make comparison of the real GDP growth of the Soviet Union and the United States during the Cold War. According to the data of the Madison Project database of the University of Groningen, in the period between 1952 and 1975, the USSR had higher economic growth in 15 of the total 24 years, and the United States has supreme growth only in 9 years from the same period. In 1964, the USSR achieved impressive economic growth of 12.9%, and in 1956 and 1960, 9.5%. The United States achieved its best result in 1959 with 7.4% GDP growth, which seems modestly compared to the best results of the Soviet Union during the long period of 24 years. The numbers show as well that the United States had a negative GDP growth during 4 years, 1954, 1958, 1974 and 1975. and the Soviet Union had a negative economic growth only 2 years from this long period of a quarter century. But the most revealing fact is that the accumulated growth of the Soviet Union for all the 24 years period is impressively ahead of the one in United States, 204 to 124%. These economic indicators show with no doubt that for a quarter of a century after the end of the World War II, the Soviet economic system proved to be significantly more successful and sustainable than the one of the USA. Russian economists and political analysts Mikhail Khazin and Sergei Gavrilenko claims that the Soviet Union had its chance to win the Cold War in the 1970s, but did not use it. The two scientists say that the Soviet Union could force its victory through using a large-scale propaganda to the world to demonstrate its more successful economic model than the one of the United States. According to the National Interest magazine, during the 1970s in the United States, the deindustrialization, the long and lost war in Vietnam, and other reasons created a very rare and severe economical situation called stagflation, which means a condition that combines altogether a high inflation, high unemployment, and low economic growth at the same time. Since the mid-1970s to the early 1980s, interest rates in the United States stayed very high, peaking in 1980 at a staggering 21%. During the first half of the 1970s, the political elite of the Communist Party of Soviet Union realized that the USSR had accumulated a considerable economic power and decided to turn to analytical centers in Moscow with an order to examine in details whether the Warsaw Pact countries could force their victory over Western capitalism. However, the answer of the analysts was surprising. They concluded that if Soviet Union tried to demonstrate through aggressive propaganda to the world its economic success, the capitalists would not allow this and most probably would start a war that is likely to be conventional but still will cause great damage to both sides. In addition, the Western leaders are very likely to convince China to attack the Soviet Union, promising to the Chinese the natural resources of Siberia, which means that in such scenario, the Warsaw Pact countries will be forced to fight in two fronts, in Western Europe against NATO countries and in East Asia against China. The political analysts in Moscow concluded that the Warsaw Pact cannot win a war on two fronts against the West and China at the same time. This conclusion made the leaders of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union to forget about any opportunity of forcing their victory over the capitalist West. According to political analyst Mikhail Khazin, until 1975, Soviet political leaders sincerely believed that the superior economic growth of the Soviet Union compared to the one of the United States would continue for a very long time and that will allow Soviets to win the competition with the capitalist West without direct military confrontation, and the communist victory is only a matter of time. But since 1975, history has experienced a complete turnaround and entirely refuted the Soviets' economic forecasts. First, in the 1980s, the Western capitalist world implemented Reaganomics, which is an economic model of a rapid GDP growth based on accumulation of debt, which has been repaid with another debt. In this economic model, the debt interest rates are being reduced after every debt cycle. Due to ideological reasons, the Warsaw Pact countries could not implement the same model of economic growth, which is why the communist countries fell behind in the race with the capitalist West, which became very obvious after the year 1985. The prolonged and exhausting for the Soviet economy war in Afghanistan between 1979 and 1989, the fall of the oil prices in the world markets in the 1980s, The Chernobyl catastrophe in 1986, like other reasons, drained the Soviet Union financially and economically and forced Mikhail Gorbachev to seek peace from the West at the end of 1989. So, back to the main question, could the Soviet Union have won the Cold War? Despite the impressive economic growth in the period 1952-1975, the answer seems that Soviet Union had no chance of winning the war neither before nor after 1975. Because in case of direct military confrontation in the 1970s, the Soviet Union would risk a war on two fronts. And with the decision to wait, the Soviet lost the competition with Western Reaganomics GDP growth based on debt accumulation. Of course, debt of the Western countries remained and even grew dramatically after the end of the Cold War, but this is a topic for another day. If this video was interesting for you, please give a like, leave a comment, subscribe and share this video with other people. If you want to see more videos like this, please consider supporting me on Patreon. For more information, check out the Patreon link in the description.